learn to make it on your own. And if you love yourself, just know you'll never be alone. I hope that you get everything you want and that you chose. I hope that it's the realest thing that you ever know. Hope you get the pretty girls that's pretty at everything. $1 million cribs, having $1 million dreams. And when you get it all, just remember one thing. Remember one thing. And one man could change the world.
Okay, good evening everyone, Mr. Joe here again, and today I'll be talking to you about Blockfolio and how to use it, and also talk about ICOs and getting a profitable altcoin. So let's get started. This is a very deep topic anyway, but I'm still going to, you know, do it in such a way that you get the real thing, and this video wouldn't have to be too long. So we'll start with Blockfolio. I was able to get a website that explains this better than I could have explained to you. I broke it down very well, so I just follow it and explain it to you. Then anything that is not clear here, I explain it to you according to my own understanding. So how to use Blockfolio. Now, Blockfolio is a must-have app for any crypto investor. It's a free app that tracks Bitcoin and altcoin prices across multiple exchanges and allows you to monitor your current portfolio. This guide will get you started with the Blockfolio app, from downloading to registering, entering your portfolio, and tracking your investments. So this app is just one of those apps that you need to have, though there are other alternatives, so it's not like it's a must get. There are other alternatives, but Blockfolio has been there, like one of the oldest in terms of coin tracking apps. So what it does for you is it can even tell you how many percentage profit you've made in a particular coin from a particular period to a particular period. Okay, it can show you how much total your portfolio have added and so on. But let's practicalize it. As you're taking this training, I expect that you take up your phone and start practicing what I'm teaching you now, because I'm doing this video with PC, but everything you are seeing on my screen is exactly as it is when you go to your mobile. So the first thing you need to do is to go to blockfolio.com and select the download link. You either choose App Store if you're using Android, or you go to App Store if you're using iPhone, or you go to Google Play if you're using Android. So just, you don't need to even go to this website, just go to your App Store, okay, with your phone and search for Blockfolio. Now when you search for it, you see this logo here. This is the Blockfolio we're talking about, and for you to know that it is the exact one that I expect you to download, you see the total number of download. By now it should be above 1 million. It should be above 1 million download. So when you see that particular one that has the highest number of downloads, it's Blockfolio, okay, and lots of reviews. I don't think they will allow other companies to just have a variation of their name. Most of these things, these companies go and block them, okay. But be sure you're downloading the right Blockfolio. So it will look like this. This is how their logo will look like. So you click on install. After you must have installed it, this is how it will now look like. Blockfolio, and your total portfolio is zero because you've not added what you have here. So once installed, launch the app, read through the tips, then tap finish. You are ready to add your investments. So now let's set up your portfolio. So Blockfolio will track the coins you hold from a list of over 2,000 assets. Simply add each coin by following these steps. Step 1. Tap the Add Coin option or the plus at the top of the screen. At the top of your screen, when you go to this app, right, when you're seeing this, look at this a plus sign here. That is where you will tap. Once you tap it, it will show you this screen, okay, where you see different projects, different coins, tokens, so, and also the search button. So the search button is for you not to waste your time in scrolling down, but just search for that particular coin which you already bought that is in your portfolio to add it up here, so that this app will now help you to track things, okay, to make life easier for you actually. So Bitcoin and Ethereum are at the top of the list. Use the search box to find others. So let's say you have Matic. You come to this list and search for Matic, okay? When you search for Matic, Matic will come up. Just like here is Lisk that we searched for here, and it came up as LSK. That's a short abbreviation for Lisk, okay? So if, let's say you bought Lisk, you want to add Lisk to this, your portfolio, Blockfolio account, so you track things with Blockfolio, you search for it and add it, okay? So tap the coin you wish to add, and after tapping it, it will now show you a screen that looks like this, okay? And where you will have to choose the trading pair which you have done here, you select the exchange. In this case, it is Binance, but once you click here on your mobile, it should show you all the exchanges that you can choose from. The good thing, why it is good for you to set it according to the particular exchange where you bought that coin or where you're keeping that coin, is because there's usually a little price fluctuation between exchanges. Not much, but it's good you get the information according to how it is with your exchange, okay? Now, you are either buying or selling or watch only, okay? Watch only means that you're setting this up so that you just use this app to be tracking what's going on with it. So if it is buy, you're putting the current price. Remember, buy doesn't mean that you're buying coin, you have any money attached to this app. No, you're just trying to set the exact same thing you did on Binance, on Bittrex, on Poloniex, on any other exchange, so that you'll be able to see, track things here. Like, you don't need to go and log into Binance. Just open your Blockfolio. Your Blockfolio will tell you whether you've made money or you are losing money just by looking at those portfolios in your Blockfolio account. So let's say you bought coin, you bought LSK on Binance. You come here, you put buy. Now, current price is this. This is the current price. This might not be the current price because I don't know when they did this review here. So trade price is this. Enter quantity. Here you put the quantity, the exact same quantity you got when you bought it. Now this trade price, you have to change it. Put the exact same price you bought it. Because if you don't put the exact same price, you will not be getting accurate information. So you go to your Binance or to your exchange and find the exact same price it was when you bought it and put it here. So it can now calculate for you whether you are in profit or loss at any material time. Now you put the exact same quantity you bought. Now total value, it will now populate it for you here. Deduct from holding. Well, don't switch this. So trade date, you put the date when you bought it. Okay, so it will also help you to analyze properly. Notes, if you want to leave any notes, you can leave, but no need for that. So that's it about that. This coin will now be added to your Blockfolio account. So you'll now be seeing things like you are in plus 7% profit, you are in minus 7% profit, stuff like that, because it will automatically calculate for you based on the price you bought and the current price, and I'll give you a percentage change, the percentage profit or percentage loss in the variation of these two prices. So that's the same thing you're going to do for all these other coins. Now, if you just want to watch a coin, you're not buying that coin, but you want to see how this coin, the movement, and you know, monitor the movement of that coin, you can just use watch only. So when you click on watch only, you now add those coins and watch the movement. Watch the movement on weekly, on daily, on monthly, and see if you can be able to master the movement and see if you can, you know, choose that trading pair to be trading with. So tap select exchange. Okay, we are done with this. You put the prices here, you put the date you bought. So when you tap save, this is exactly how your Blockfolio will now look like. But not all these coins, because remember, you just added one. This, you still do the same process for all the coins you are interested in, or the coins that or the coins that you are actually watching or trading, okay? So as you can see from this Blockfolio account, this person just has $5 as total portfolio value. He bought SRP, and his SRP is giving him 2%. He bought XMR, is giving him 7%. He He bought LTC at the rate of 213. It's giving him 3+3% LSK, just like that, Ethereum, and so on. So this is how it's going to populate and show you whether you are in plus or you are in minus. Then you can also set alarm. This alarm clock sign you see here, the alert, is to set alarm and maybe like Bitcoin now is currently at $7,200. So you might say, okay, I want to short when price gets to 7,400. So you come to your portfolio under BTC and put alarm here. When you click on this alarm, you now set the alarm according to how you want it. You can say the app should alert you when Bitcoin hits 7,400. So when your app start beeping, you know that Bitcoin has got to that. So what do? You enter online and enter your trade. That's another good feature of this app. So go through the same steps for each coin you hold. You can sort your coin by tapping the column title and zoom in on each coin's recent progression by tapping it. I've said this before. Okay. So, and it also shows you the charts. So I don't like to read charts with phone. So most times I don't use this particular feature. Like when you click here, details to show you the chart as it is on Bittrex or on Binance or on the exchange that you actually choose. It will show you the high, it will show you the low, it will show you the bid price, the ask price, the volume, and the change. Just exactly what you see in those exchanges. That's what the portfolio will show you. So it saves you that time of going to your exchange to log in and all that. So you might just be driving and then you want to see how things are. You can just park, open your portfolio. The portfolio will just show you everything, how things are. You close it and continue your journey. Instead of wasting the time that you want to log into your Binance or Bittrex and so on. So removing assets, also very, very easy. Removing an asset deletes all your trades associated with it. Proceed with caution. So one, launch portfolio, tap the coin you want to remove from your portfolio, tap the trash icon by the coin name and the coin will be removed. So this is the trash icon here, which is telling you whether you should recycle it, like remove it. So when you click it, you see the warning sign and click yes, you're willing to remove it, and that's it. It will trash that particular one. So the alerts is very simple. I've explained it to you. This thing that looks like a bell, okay? You click on it and you set your alerts. Now let's see how the platform will look when you want to set alerts. So check you are using the right exchange for price and adjust if necessary. So trading pair, you've chosen your trading pair, you choose your exchange, you set threshold target. Now above, let's say it's Bitcoin, if you're setting above, you're saying if it is above 7,400, you're saying that if Bitcoin hits 7,401 and above, it should alert you. Okay, now this is the current price. Then below, if you are using below, you're saying that, let's say you say below 7,400, you're saying that if Bitcoin goes below 7,400, that's like 7,399 and below, it should alert you. So above is usually used when the coin is still down and you're expecting to come up to a stage. Then when it comes up to a stage, it's either you are going back to go and take profit or you are shorting from that place, depending on your trading strategy, okay, or what you want the market to remind you about. And below is usually used when you think you feel the coin is going to come down, maybe support. You understand? So when it hits that support, you are now saying alert me so that I can go and close my trade manually. But these things can be set automatically anyway, okay, on the exchanges. But the folio just makes it easier for you because it can alert you of how the market is doing even when the exchanges cannot. Okay, so I think that is it about that. Then another good feature about Blockfolio is the chart. If you go to the app, you will see this arrow sign. Okay, you click on it to show you the chart, but I don't use charts on phone. I like to use my PC, and I have a very big PC, like large PC for my chart. So that is about portfolio. The major thing you need to know about this app is that it just makes your life easier. It makes it easier. It alerts you of movements in the market. Okay, so you don't have to miss any opportunity. Okay, it also alerts you of profits, depending on what you set, you can set your alarms, okay? It also shows you the percentage profit, percentage loss. You don't have to come and start using the percentage calculator to calculate again. It will automatically calculate it for you here. So when you just go into the app, it will show you your total portfolio value. How much do you have? Is it increasing or is it decreasing? Okay, so from that you now know which coin is doing well, which coin is not doing well, and see how you can twist things when you now go back to your exchange. So that is it about Blockfolio. I believe this app will help you. It helped me when I started out. It's a very nice app, and I recommend that you should download it and see how it works. So if you have any question as it relates to Blockfolio, remember you're doing it with your phone. So any question at all, direct it to me on the WhatsApp group. So let's head over to the next thing. I've explained Blockfolio and how to use it. So we are going to be talking about ICOs and getting altcoins. So ICOs, what is ICO? ICO means initial coin offering. Now, if it is in the traditional parlance, when it has to do with stock market, when a company wants to go public, it issues an IPO to the public, like initial public offering. That's inviting the public to come and buy into the shares of the company. Okay? Inviting the company, the general public to come and buy into their shares. Okay? Into the shares of the company. Okay? Either the company can be a public company, can be a private company. In private companies, we talk about private placements and all that. Public companies, we talk about the IPOs, initial public offer. Okay, public placements and all that. So, but that's in the crypto sphere, it's just a change of terminology. For the traditional stock market, we call it IPO. For cryptocurrencies, we call it ICOs. It's just the medium in which new coins are introduced into the market. Okay. So calling on the general public to come and buy into this coin. So when you buy, what you are now holding is the coin or the token, okay? As against shares, if it is stock that you are buying, okay? Now, there are things to consider when you want to pick an ICO. A lot of things you need to do your research. But I have to warn you, we've done all this research and we failed in the past. We've made some good money with ICOs. And we've also lost some good money with ICOs. Why? Because you can never be 100% sure with this. Let's get down to it. For you to pick a profitable ICO, you need to first of all examine the team. And when we are talking about the team, one way to be sure of the right team is to go to their social profiles. So usually some of them will put their social media, LinkedIn. Their LinkedIn profile, because LinkedIn looks professional, okay. But for me, I will even go and research the particular person in all the social media. If he does, he or she does not have much going on the social media, it's possible that he just created that account for the purpose of the ICO. So that's a red flag for me. That's not to say that people who do not like public lifestyle, but then when I look at your social profile, I already know whether you're lying or you're telling the truth. So that is one of the ways. But even this cannot even 100% protect you, because a lot of people are even willing to dent their image just to make money, just to collect money from unsuspecting members of the public. So that is one way I check. Then, what is the project all about? That is another thing I check to see. Is it a feasible project? Is it something that is attainable? Okay. And they have a good team. Yes. If they have a good team and they don't have a good project, they will still fail. So if the project is something that interests me, remember, you put your money where your mouth is. You don't just invest in things you don't have interest in. Some people might be interested in artificial intelligence. Some people might be interested in trading platforms. Some people, a whole lot of things in this industry. So you choose what interests you. So when you put your money, you know that the passion is fueling it. Even if anything happens, you have learned and you just followed your passion and nothing much about it. But when you just see any ICO, any project, you just enter, even when you don't have interest in that project, in that particular niche, how will you be able to research to be sure that these people are telling you the truth or they are telling you a lie? You see that? So you have to pay attention to projects. Then the third thing is the marketing team. Be sure that the team behind this token or this coin, they have the right marketing team. They have the right marketing tactics. because it is all fluff. Like, everything is about marketing as it relates to the cryptocurrency space. All those things you see in the white paper, blah, 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 they will draw a planet, you know, draw a jet for you and all that, you know, things that they want to do. Yes, those things are just dreams. It is not there. So, and they are hoping that it will come there. But the hallmark of it is you buy low, you sell high. So in ICO stage, you're buying low. You're expecting that these things will triple, quadruple, and so on, and so that you can cash out. So the only thing that can make these things work that way is a promising team that knows how to market. So when they know how to market, they're going to, like, any step they take, they inform the public, any step. So that will now give the public the confidence to come in. So as more and more people are coming in, price is going up. Remember the laws of demand and supply. When more people want something, price goes up. When more people, less people want something, and more people are want to sell it off, price goes down. So, but when more people are looking for this coin, it will encourage initial investors, those who put into the ICOs, not to sell. So when they are not selling as much as they should, price will just keep going up. Okay. But when the team, they don't know how to do their marketing, and their people are not buying in, what happens? The people who are doing ICO will just say, okay, since our money is going to be lost, let us just cut it, you know, cut our loss. And maybe if you had invested $1,000 and it's now what, like $500, you say, okay, let me just take it instead of it to go to zero. You understand? And that is how everybody dumps on the market, and the token goes far below the ICO price. We've seen that. We've bought a whole lot of coin, and some scam coin like Transcodium, like so many of them that we bought that didn't do well. But in the midst of that, we still say we were lucky back then in 2016, 2017. We still bought coins like Litrinium and the rest of, and some other good coins that made us millions. So, but the truth is, the time for ICOs, the era is far gone to an extent. It might be resurrected tomorrow, who knows? But it's good you just have the knowledge. But I don't advise you to just go now and start buying ICOs. Instead of buying ICOs, you look into IEOs, initial exchange offering. That is a better way, you know, a better way of bringing in coin, because it is now being regulated by the exchanges, and the exchanges wouldn't want to bring in something that is not good into their marketplace. So all these ICO calendars we used to use back in the days, I actually loaded them up. I'm not seeing something good. Okay, I think this one is still here, Coin Codex. Now look at this Coin Codex. The easiest way for you to know about ICOs, upcoming ICOs, is for you to just go to Google and search for ICO calendar. When you search for ICO calendar, it's going to bring up a whole lot of calendars that you now see. Ongoing projects, upcoming ICOs, ongoing ICOs, upcoming ICOs, ongoing. You say that their public offer is already in place, while the upcoming are those that are still expecting to come in, and they'll give you date. Now let's look at what we have here. We have Corito, current stage, ICO stage, ends in 7 hours. Platform was built on the Ethereum platform. Start date, March 15th. They started offering this token on March 15th. End date, April 18th. And today is what? April 18th is ending today. Rating, nada, no rating here. But this rating is somehow, you don't have to depend on it, because these people who have this website, they are the ones that rate. And when they rate, most times they rate according to the your pocket, like how this team fund their pocket. So most of them will just pay these people to put these ratings, and you that don't know how to do your research will just see, they have 5 ratings, so let me buy it, I think it's a good coin. No, you have to be very careful, because even in the US back then, when we had the financial crisis, I think that was the 2008 financial crisis, the real estate bubble and all that. Remember that we had rating companies, world-class rating companies, that were rating a whole lot of funds that was moving in the market as good funds, and they were rating some companies that were not doing well as companies that are profitable. But if you check the books of these companies, they were super, super in depth. Okay, so the bubble was just going until it busted. So that was when we now understood that even though they are US company, people, and those companies came out and told us to our face that what they were doing was it was just mere recommendation. Imagine that. There was just mere recommendation that they didn't, their ratings are not like financial advice and stuff. So they were just trying to save their name. So don't trust in all these ratings. It can be formulated, it can be forged, okay? And it can be bought with money. But let's say you want to do this ICO. It's very simple. You can open it up. This one is Lion. This one is Leon. This one is Envision. And so on. It's a lot of projects. Even though people are no longer buying ICOs that much, look at projects everywhere. You see this one? It's 4.5% rating. Corium. Let me open it. So, but to be honest, I don't buy ICOs anymore. I do not buy ICOs anymore. Yeah, that's it. I don't. So this is Corato ICO, is ongoing. Here you will see their website. You can go to their website. You can go to their white paper. It's under the white paper. You see the team and everything about this project. You can go to their Twitter. You can go to their LinkedIn, Facebook, Medium, Explorer, etc. Okay. So that's it. From here you will get all the links that you need, you know, to start your research. And one of the major places you will start, or the two most important places, is the website and the white paper. So you download the white paper and you go to their website and you get to know more about this project. I think that is it about ICOs. Just be very, very careful with ICOs. Be very, very careful. When we made money with this, that era has passed. Maybe that era will come again. But for now, we've seen good products in this era. Good products that even if it was in 2017, they would have made serious money and they would have been doing well in the market. And they still come, do their ICOs, and they still flop because they didn't raise a lot of good money to actualize the project. So it just fails. And when it fails, do they refund the money? No, your money is gone. Okay, so you have to be very, very careful. A lot of people made money with ICOs, but we just have to accept that period is almost gone. Almost. So another way you can make money with ICOs is by promoting it. So when you register and then you buy, usually in their website they will have a referral link, and in that referral link you can use it to invite others to buy, and when they buy you get a bonus, like you can see here, 30% bonus when you buy anyway, but they still have referral links when you invite others to partake in this ICO. So I think that is where I'll be stopping on ICO. You just go to Google and search for ICO calendar, and you will see a whole lot of them. Some of them have closed shop, probably because the industry is no longer fruitful as it used to be before. Okay, but you still see, like we just saw. We have this, we have CoinDesk, we have CoinCodex, we have blah blah blah, a whole lot of them. And the ICO calendars we used to use back in the days, I didn't even see any of them here. So probably they are no longer ranking because they are no longer updating their website. Or maybe they are even out of business. Okay, so this is CoinTelegraph. They also have ICO calendar. This is the ongoing airport. They have Awoka. Upcoming, we have Quick Protocol, the fourth pillar, Oka, and so on. Past. Just like that. Okay? So, this is where we'll be stopping today on ICO. So, let's look at the last thing in our menu, which is getting altcoins. How do you know good altcoins to buy? How do you know? I don't know, but I'll tell you what I know. Okay, let's look at coinmarketcap.com. I heard Binance was making move to acquire CoinMarketCap. Probably they've acquired it silently. Who knows? Binance is just buying up everywhere, everything they see in the space, just like Facebook used to do, the social platforms, and Google used to do to other tech companies. So I'm having a very poor internet, so I'm going to pause this video. Check on my internet and resume it. Okay, so here we are, coinmarketcap.com. Okay, Now, under CoinMarketCap, remember we are talking about how to choose profitable altcoins. As you can see, the past 24 hours has been so bullish. It's been green everywhere, green everywhere, green everywhere, green everywhere. Okay, so CoinMarketCap is where you see altcoins. So I will advise you, if you are truly serious about being in this industry, to trade between the top 10 coins as a newbie. Top 10 coins by market cap. So as you can see, Bitcoin is the king, is the highest market cap. It has 132 billion market cap. Ethereum is the second, 20 billion market cap. SRP is the third, 8 billion. Theta is actually a stable coin. It doesn't truly move that much. As you can see, it moves small, very tiny, but it doesn't really move. It's meant to be like a stable coin. $1 is $1. Okay. Bitcoin Cash is the fifth with 4 billion market cap. Then Bitcoin SV, the fork from BCH, has 3 billion market cap. Litecoin, 2 billion. Binance Coin, 2 billion, 2.5 billion. EOS 2.5 billion, Texas 1.6 billion. Okay, then we have Chainlink and so on. So, as you advance, you can increase this number from 10 to 20. Okay, as you advance, also you increase it to 30, to 40, to 50, to 60, to 70, to 80, to 90, to 100. Do not go below 100. As you can see, even this one, the last one here, the 100th coin here, just has 34 million market share, $34 million market share. And that's small. It can be manipulated. It can. We know, we've seen whales that have close to $500 million. So somebody that has that kind of money can come here and manipulate this market. You know, pump and dump this market and go his or her way. So, but in this kind of market like Bitcoin, with billions of dollars in market cap, it's not that easy to manipulate. Yes, manipulations happen, because remember, Jeff Bezos, you know, he has some big money. We have so many people that have some big billions that can come into the market and still control how things go. It's not like the forex market, but even the forex market, there's still the banks still come together to do their thing. So, but it's always good to go, you know, play where the big guys play, so that at least once you watch how these whales play their game, it's not likely that you're going to lose a whole lot of money on Bitcoin, as you will lose in all these coins down here, because these coins can be easily manipulated. Okay, unlike Bitcoin and this top 10. So that's how I choose my altcoins, top 10. Then in that top 10 or top 20, you now go and analyze them. And you don't really need to have like 100 coins, 200, no. You just need to have like 5 coins, 10 coins in your list, or even 3 coins or 2 coins that you're trading. And you choose them according to their charts. When this one is down, this one is up. When this one is down, this one is up. Okay, so you check it. If let's say you're trading on Bitcoin and you see that Bitcoin chart is looking, you know, the probability is not, you are not even sure of what is going to happen in the next moment, what do? You leave Bitcoin now. You probably will even leave Ethereum, leave all these coins that flow with Bitcoin, and maybe go down to, let's say, Texas, okay, EOS. Some of them have a mind of their own. Binance Coin, they have a mind of their own. They can actually do and undo anytime they want, even though they still follow Bitcoin when they want to also. So you can go check that. If that chart is good, you flow with that. Okay? So that's how I choose. CoinMarketCap. This is the best place where you get to know. Now, if you look very well, you will see. It shows you almost everything you need to know about this coin. Now, look at it. Name. The ranking. The name. The market cap tells you how much money is in that capital. Is in that market. How much money is in that market. How much money. How much is that company worth? You can decide to call it company or that token worth. Okay, this is what it is worth currently. Sometimes it increases and decreases according to how much money is flowing into the market. Okay, now what is the price? As you can see, the current price of Bitcoin is $7,229. The volume for 24 hours volume, how much money is in the market in the past 24 hours? $32 billion. You see, that's a whole lot of liquidity in the market. But this is even small, because there are times you will see serious money when there's big move, when the big move is about to happen. You know, the 24 hours rule will just keep rising for them to do what they want to do in the market. So circulating supply, we have 18 million BTC supply. Remember, the total supply of Bitcoin is, I think, 21 million BTC. So how do you know about these things? You know about them from their white papers. That's why I talked to you about ICOs. So you understand, if you still want to get Bitcoin white paper, it's out there. Ethereum, SRP, all of them, their white paper is out there in the internet. Just search it on Google and you get it, and you look at the total supply. That's something I did not tell you during ICO, you know, in choosing good ICOs. Back then, we used to believe that those that their supply is small will appreciate better. But that's not 100% correct, because there are those that their supply is just so big, but they are giving enormous return on investment. For example, is SRP. SRP supply is just so big. As you can even see, circulating supply here, 44 billion tokens are there. But I tell you, SRP used to turn up as one of the top performing coins whenever there is a bull market. Okay? So, that is not entirely correct, but there's still an atom of truth in it. Okay, because if the token is too big, if the circulation is too big, then it will take an enormous amount of money to push it up. Take serious money to push it up. Okay, and the developers might just be dumping tokens on the market, dumping tokens and cashing out, and then the price will just keep going down. So it also shows you the 24 hours change, how much money has been made or lost in the last 24 hours. As you can see from this top 100, it's only this USD coin, and I think USD coin is a stable coin that is a minus. Okay, this is not significant, it's very, very small. Okay, then we have Paxos Standard, this is also a stable coin. We have Binance USD, that's BUSD. We have Bitcoin Gold actually lost. So all these ones are stable coin apart from Bitcoin Gold. I think it's only Bitcoin Gold in this list. Okay, what is this one? Multi Collateral. Veg, Bitcoin. Okay, Bitcoin is actually one that has done serious loss, 7.4% loss. Digitex, 2% loss. Insular, 4% loss. So, but in all, if you had bought all these coins, let's say you have small token of them, you see that on the general note, you would be in profit, because like Ethereum is giving 7%, BTC is giving 2%, SRP 2%, 3%. And you'll be looking at these things as small, but just calculate 7% of 1 billion, 7% of 10 million, 7% of 20 million, 70% of even 1 million. Okay? You will know that yes, you know, these percentages are not truly small. It's when you're dealing with small money that you look at it as small. Okay? So I think this is where I'll be stopping for this training. I need you to ask me your questions. Remember, we've not gone deep into the chart, the fundamental and technical analysis. That will show you how to truly use your chart, how to truly use your chart in picking these coins. Don't worry, we'll get there. We'll get there. Just taking it step by step. Ask your questions. Download the apps you need to download, so that when we start flowing, it will now be easy for you, because then I won't be explaining all these small things. I'll just be treating you as an expert who has known these other small components that surrounds it. And so when you are in the center now, we'll now be talking like professionals, like someone who has come up to age in the industry. Okay, so at that stage, when I'm teaching you true technical analysis, you'll be able to pick it and practicalize, and it will work for you. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Click on the subscribe button to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and also ask your questions in our WhatsApp group or under this video, and an admin will be there to answer it. Thank you. I made myself Mr. Joe. Have a nice time.